The story of Hajj. What is Hajj? What is Hajj? Hajj is a sacred pilgrimage that is required for every Muslim at least once in their life. It is one of the fifth pillars of Islam. Each year, millions of Muslims across the world travel to perform Hajj in Mecca, modern-day Saudi Arabia. When does Hajj take place? Hajj takes place during the same period each year, during the month of Dhul Hijjah, the 12th month in the Islamic calendar. Hajj begins on the 8th of Dhul Hijjah and lasts until the 13th of Dhul Hijjah. This year, Hajj is taking place between 26th of June to the 1st of July 2023 in the Gregorian calendar. Why do Muslims go for Hajj or pilgrimage? Hajj is an annual pilgrimage to Mecca taken on by able Muslims who should complete this at least once in their lives. This makes up one of the five pillars of Islam and brings with it great rewards, benefits and complete forgiveness of any sin from Allah. Okay, we're gonna watch a video of how the story of Prophet Ibrahim and his son and his wife.
Hajj is undeniably a great journey a Muslim took on his life. A journey of sacrifice, self-discovery, and all above a journey of servitude and obedience to God Almighty. And in case you're wondering where it all began, it began in the time of Prophet Ibrahim in his older years. Ibrahim was commanded by Allah to take his wife Hajar and his newborn son Ishmael to live in the barren desert plains of Makkah, and a land which was by all means inhospitable, only to leave them with nothing more than some dates and a flask of water. As Ibrahim became to leave, his wife Hajar initially cries out, "To where are you going? To whom will you leave us?" She frantically repeats this again until she asks, "Has Allah commanded you to do this?" Which Ibrahim replies, "Yes." "Being every woman of God," she replies, "if that is the case, then Allah will not let us down." Shortly after the dates and water used up, Hajar became to search for help. She begins to leave a baby behind and proceeds to ascend the mountain of Safa. She looks far and wide, but to her disappointment, sees no one else. She races back down to check on the child and then continues on her search. This time ascending the mountain of Safa. She travels, sees back and forth the mountains of Safa and Marwa, until one narration states that Angel Jibreel ascends with the tip of his wing and hits the ground, spots the well of Zamzam, with the water being the source of life. This event served as the beginning of what became the city of Mecca. This miraculous event encapsulated in the safe or running between Safa and Marwa that Muslims perform in these days of Hajj. A few years later, Ibrahim returned to unite with his beloved wife and son Ishmael. Shortly after his arrival, Ibrahim witnessed a dream made by a believer to him that he is to sacrifice his son. Of course, this was an extreme test and a trial. Yet both Ibrahim and Ishmael complete willingly. Ibrahim takes his son up to the mountain and places his son blindfolded on a rock. just as Ibrahim was about to make the sacrifice, God commands the knife not to cut and explains Ibrahim that he has passed the test. A sheep is brought in exchange for the sacrifice, and that this would go on. To form the basis of the sacrificial animal slaughter, Muslims perform the end of Hajj. Few years pass, and once Ishmael reaches his youth, Allah commands him to, alongside his son, build the Kaaba, the house of God on earth. Upon the completion of his monumental task, Allah puts in and commands him the people to perform the pilgrimage of Hajj. Bear in mind that he is still in the middle of the desert, and the city of Mecca was extremely small. Yet once again, in sheer obedience to God, Ibrahim fulfills and calls the people and proclaim the people the Hajj pilgrimage. They will come to you on foot and every lean camel. They will come from every distant pass. Today, that very call has been answered, and the fruits of Ibrahim's sincerity and obedience to God can be seen in full effect. Every year, millions of upon millions of people have traveled across all corners of the world to visit the house of God and walk in the footsteps of Ibrahim. Yet the story doesn't end there. For it is while is on his own pilgrimage that he is approached by Satan being the sole enemy to whom he tries to corrupt his pilgrimage. However, in defiance of Satan, Ibrahim pellets him with stones and overcomes him. This event has been embodied in the army upholding Covenant of Hajj, whereby Muslims symbolically cast away Satan by painting these same areas with stone. These most important key events of Ibrahim went on to become the manasik or rituals of Hajj. In one way or another, we can see that Hajj is in fact a celebration of the life of Ibrahim, the embodiment of his path. Allah commands his believers in the Quran in more than one occasion to follow the path of Ibrahim. And just like that, every year for Hajj, Muslims will walk in the footsteps of the greatest man to ever live, Ibrahim. May peace and blessings of Allah be upon Ibrahim, his family, and the Nabi Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
And that is it. This is the story of Hajj. Thank you for watching.